necessary and sufficient condition for Riemann integrability. The statement of this theorem is necessary and sufficient condition for a bounded function f to be Riemann integrable over the closed interval a comma b is for each epsilon is greater than 0, there exists a partition p of the closed interval a comma b such that 0 less than or equals to u of p comma f minus l of p comma f is less than epsilon. This statement consists of two parts, necessary part and sufficient part, or we say if part and only if part, or we can simply rewrite the statement as a bounded function f to be a Riemann integrable on the closed interval a comma b if and only if for each epsilon is greater than 0 there exists a partition p of a comma b such that the difference between upper and lower dot box sum must be less than epsilon. Let us prove this statement. Necessary condition. What is the necessary condition here? Here, in the necessary condition, we are given that the function, the bounded function, is Riemann integrable. That is, let f belong to R of a comma b. That is, let f be a Riemann integrable function on the closed interval a comma b. Now, what do you have to prove? We have to prove that for a given epsilon, there exists a partition P such that 0 less or equal to U of P comma F minus L of P comma F is less than epsilon. Since F is Riemann integrable, by the definition of Riemann integrable, upper Riemann integral is equals to lower Riemann integral. That is, integral a to b bar f is equals to integral a bar to b f. Let epsilon be greater than 0. Then by Darboux's theorem, we have u of p comma f is less than integral a to b bar f plus epsilon by 2, and l of p comma f is greater than integral a bar to b f minus epsilon by 2. That is, upper Darboux sum is less than upper Riemann integral plus epsilon, but here we are taken epsilon by 2. Lower Darboux sum is greater than the lower Riemann integral minus epsilon, but here we are taken epsilon by 2, because whenever epsilon is positive and small, epsilon by 2 is also positive and it will be less than epsilon. Therefore, if you take epsilon by 2 here, there will not be any problem at all. Let us call. Now, L of p comma f is greater than integral from a to b f minus epsilon by 2 implies minus of L of p comma f is less than minus integral a bar to b f plus epsilon by 2. That is, we multiply this inequality with minus 1. Whenever we multiply an inequality with a negative number, the inequality will be reversed. Therefore, here the greater than symbol becomes less than. We will call this as inequality 1 and this inequality as 2. 1 plus 2 implies, the 1 is upper dot box sum is less than upper Riemann integral plus epsilon by 2. Inequality 2 is minus LPF is less than minus integral from A bar to B F plus epsilon by 2. Now we are going to add these two. When you add, we have to add left hand side and we have to add right hand side. But here, see that the same inequality we have. Therefore, there will not be any problem of adding. Since we have the same inequality in both inequations, simply we can add the left hand side as well as we can add the terms on the right hand side. Therefore, u of p comma f is less than a to b bar f plus epsilon by 2. We are going to add with minus l of p comma f. So minus l of p comma f. What is the value of minus l of p comma f? Minus l of p comma f is less than minus integral from a bar to b f plus epsilon by 2. Since f is Riemann integrable, as we have discussed just now, the upper Riemann integral is equals to lower Riemann integral. That is, the values of upper Riemann integral and lower Riemann integral are equal. Transposing the lower Riemann integral to the left hand side, we get upper Riemann integral minus lower Riemann integral is equal to 0. That is, this upper Riemann integral and the lower Riemann integral both will be having the same value, and hence these two get cancelled. Therefore, we get UPF minus LPF is less than epsilon by 2 plus epsilon by 2. Also, we know that the upper dot box sum is always greater than or equals to lower dot box sum for any partition P. That is, for all P belongs to script P of A comma B. That is, for all partition P belongs to set of all partitions of the closed interval A comma B. Therefore, the difference is always positive. Therefore, the difference UPF minus LPF is always positive, and hence this inequation can be written as 0 less or equals to UPF minus LPF, which is less than epsilon by 2 plus epsilon by 2. But epsilon by 2 plus epsilon by 2 value is epsilon. Therefore, 0 less or equals to UPF minus LPF is less than epsilon. Thus, F belongs to R of A comma B implies, given epsilon greater than 0, there exists a partition P of the closed interval A comma B such that 0 less or equal to U of P comma F minus L of P comma F is less than epsilon. Hence, the condition is necessary. We shall now prove the sufficient condition. In the sufficient condition, we are given epsilon greater than 0, suppose that there exists a partition P of the closed interval A comma B such that the difference of upper Riemann sum and lower Riemann sum is less than epsilon. What you got to prove here? We have to prove that F is Riemann integrable on the closed interval A comma B. Since 0 less than or equal to U of P comma F minus L of P comma F less than epsilon is given, this implies U of P comma F is less than L of P comma F plus epsilon. That is, we simply transposed L of P comma F to the right hand side. We recall that the properties of dot box sums say upper Riemann integral is always less than or equals to upper dot box sum, and the lower Riemann integral is always greater than or equal to the lower dot box sum. And this lower dot box sum can be written as L of P comma F is less than or equals to integral a bar to b f. Above inequality implies, since integral a to b bar f is less than or equal to u of p comma f, but what is u of p comma f? U of p comma f is less than L of p comma f plus epsilon. That is, this is less than L of p comma f. What is L of p comma f? L of p comma f is less than or equals to integral a bar to b f. Here we have to add epsilon 2. Therefore, when you add epsilon, we have to add epsilon on both sides. Therefore, plus epsilon plus epsilon. That is, the upper dot box sum is greater than or equals to upper Riemann integral, but this upper dot box sum is less than lower dot box sum plus epsilon, but the lower dot box sum is less than or equals to lower Riemann integral. Therefore, we have integral from a to b bar f less than or equal to upf less than lpf plus epsilon less than or equal to integral a bar to b f plus epsilon. Our aim is to show that f is Riemann integrable. That is, we have to show that upper Riemann integral is equals to lower Riemann integral. Therefore, now we will skip the upper and lower dot box sums. Therefore, we can write integral from a bar to b f, which is less than integral a bar to b f plus epsilon. That is, the upper and lower dot box sums are not required here. Therefore, we simply eliminated those two. By using the transitive property, we have written integral from a to b bar f less than integral a bar to b f plus epsilon. What is the value of epsilon? Epsilon is positive. Therefore, we can write the upper Riemann integral is simply less than or equals to the lower Riemann integral, because epsilon is small but it is positive. Here we have eliminated epsilon. That is, we have eliminated some positive value from here. Therefore, the less than symbol becomes less than or equal. That is, the upper Riemann integral is less than or equals to lower Riemann integral, called as 1. But we know that from the properties of Riemann integral, upper Riemann integral is always greater than or equals to the lower Riemann integral for any partition. Therefore, upper Riemann integral is greater than or equal to lower Riemann integral. We call it as 2. From 1 and 2, 1 says that the upper Riemann integral is less than or equals to lower Riemann integral. 2 says that upper Riemann integral is greater than or equals to the lower Riemann integral. Therefore, from 1 and 2, we have upper Riemann integral is equals to lower Riemann integral. This implies f is Riemann integrable. That is, f belongs to R of a comma b. This completes the proof. This theorem is also sometimes known as Cauchy criteria for integrability.